Wish we could stay 18. Get a little too high, stay in bed and daydream. I wish I could fix things. If I took it all back, would you come over, take me to your studio apartment? Kissing in the dark and staying with my roommates from home. But I used your good grace to show my two faces. I deserve to end up alone.
We're up bright and early on a Sunday. I gotta get a bunch of work done. I went out on Friday with like Jack and Pete, heading into Brooklyn. So my beautiful landlord needs to get laid. Went in with Jack to meet Peter.
Where is he? Where's that beautiful man? There he is.
Dude, he has gone to every fucking sporting event in the East Coast, the West Coast. We went out in Brooklyn and of course I left my credit card at the bar for the third time this summer. If anyone has any tips on how to not leave a credit card at a bar, he would save me a lot of time, a lot of money, a lot of stress, a lot of subway tickets, phone calls with Chase. That credit card I just literally got 2 days ago and then immediately left it at the bar. I don't know why I do that. I think it's because they made it so easy to, as soon as you lose it or damage a card, you just go on the website, replace, smack that fucking button. Yesterday I went to this thing called Little Pier. It's like, or Little Island. It's like Pier 55 in New York. You guys have probably seen like Instagram posts on it or whatever. This is a new pier that they put up in New York with these little like fucking steps. They're like little circle mountain things. But my family, I was extremely hungover and sweaty, but my grandparents, who had been stuck in Florida for like the last 2 years since COVID started, I hadn't seen them since before that, so they were in town for like 2 or 3 weeks, so I've been spending a shitload of time with them. I keep having to travel to New Jersey, which sucks. I'm going back to New Jersey today for like a little family barbecue. Went to the pier. Man, I haven't vlogged in a while. My arm's getting fucking tired. I'm about to go to actually that coffee shop over there, I think. I think that's where I got this. I don't know. I just be walking around in circles in the morning. I always try to get out and get some sunlight. Definitely behind on my work right now. I haven't filmed anything for the upcoming week. I want to get a little something for Tony. This makes me so fucking uncomfortable walking around, shooting, vlogging. I'm not really sure why, because I've been doing it for so long. In the same way that when I see people taking pictures on the street, Instagram people like posing in front of weird fucking murals or stupid ass designs, it's cringy and I hate seeing it. When I see other people doing this, I'm like, what the fuck are they doing? So then it makes me think of how I look and then I get uncomfortable, which is why I fucking hate doing this. Which is why I'm gonna stop now. All right, I have something weird to get off my chest. I'd like debated whether or not I even wanted to include this, but I feel like just in case for some reason someone in my physical vicinity saw this and they're like, dude, what the fuck, you know, I wanted to get it out there first to beat the rumors and the reports. Okay, I will be 100% healthy by training camp. Come in here. All right, so for a while, I'm gonna turn the AC off for a second. So for a long time recently, I've been struggling sleeping, like legitimately horrible sleep. Every day I wake up, I'm like, my eyes are super, super heavy. I'm trying to figure out why. First, it was like, I've been seeing a girl and I was like, I literally can't sleep in a bed with another person or I get horrible, horrible sleep. So that was like 3 or 4 nights a week. And I was like, I'm just going to continue taking L's to take other dubs. Drop some congratulations on the sex in the comments. I very much appreciate that. Then I'm like, okay, that stopped. Is it just stress? I'm very stressed all the time, but like that never stopped me from sleeping. Then I started to think of like the different common denominators between what the fuck is wrong with this place and what's different between all the other places that I've lived in. We can move in a little bit. We'll open up the lighting. So you can see in here, we have big windows with a lot of light, okay? And in the morning, I close them, right? I try to get blackout blinds, but like too big, they don't really like cover anything. And I've realized I'm one of those people that needs a very, very dark room to sleep. I don't know if that's a normal thing, because I've been with people before who are like, I love when natural light comes in and wakes me up. And I'm like, fuck that. So I have gone under reconstruction to try to make my windows as dark as possible so in the morning I can be in a pitch black room and actually fucking sleep. So what I've done is I started ordering like random, first I went on like YouTube and I started searching like best way to black out your bedroom, right? And people started doing like do-it-yourself hacks, best things for like under $5. And I found this thing which will like black it out. I haven't put these up on the windows yet, but the first thing I came across is, you know, when you think of different materials, what's something that's like completely non-transparent? What's something that light cannot pass through? Tinfoil. So I grabbed a fuckload of tinfoil and I was like, I need to sleep. This is getting bad. I took tinfoil and I put it on my fucking windows. And so no light comes through. I want to preface by saying I'm completely aware about how fucking psycho and serial killer-esque this looks. And I would probably fire Tony if I went over to his apartment and he had a window like this. But we're just waiting on a few different things that I ordered to actually get proper blackout accessories for it. And I'll say, I put this up 2 days ago and I've slept till 9:30 both days. We have found the fucking problem, which means Tony, I get to go out more. We can go fucking party more. I've been able to work the last 2 days like a normal fucking human being. Sleep is very important, all right? If you need to be in a blackout room, tinfoil. Tinfoil works. It's fucking weird, and you don't want anybody else to know that you're doing it unless you want to broadcast it out to everybody that knows you, both internet and real life. I haven't put the tinfoil on here yet. I think I'm going to let that slide because not too much light comes through there, but we're going to do some other blacklight material, and I'm going to sleep again, and the bags under my eyes are going to go away, and you're going to get... That was supposed to be like a really energetic version of Nick, but like a... That was why I wanted to let you know that I look like an alien guy, and I know that I know that I look like an alien guy. Maybe I am a fucking alien guy. I never said I wasn't. I'm just saying this shit works if you're trying to sleep in a room that needs to be dark. There's just too much natural light here. I know that's like a third world fucking or first world rich people problems. Too much natural light in my bedroom, but like fuck natural light. The last two apartments I've lived in, both of which you guys have gotten apartment tours for, I didn't have a single bedroom in both bedrooms combined. Not the one in Hell's Kitchen, not the one in Brooklyn. So I was sleeping like a fucking, like a weirdo who didn't, I shouldn't have slapped it. It's gonna fucking come down. If I wake up early tomorrow morning and I see the tinfoil down, that's on Tony. Fired. Like, if someone came into my room and like saw that, she'd probably put a ring on this shit. Yo, we're literally trapped in our apartment right now. Like, the door doesn't open. Dude, just unlock it.
It is unlocked.
Both of these fucking things are unlocked. We can't open the door. The only way Tony got in was by kicking in the door through the other side.
We need to reverse kick it.
It's so fucking tight right here.
Look out.
It's like open here, and then it gets up here. I don't really know what to do. We're stuck. Tony wanted to leave to get a haircut from some fucking schmuck across the street or something.
Francisco.
Give him clout. He doesn't deserve
that shit. Shout out Francisco.
Nah, yeah, Lindor. And I said, listen, you know what this means? It's destiny that I need to line Tony up. Sit your ass down in the chair. Let me get my clippers. I got a lot of different clippers. I can fade you up. Come on.
You down to just do a buzz cut?
Hell yeah. I can't fuck
that. Just all off.
I can't fuck that up, can I?
Probably not.
You're also gonna, you're gonna wanna put in your Hinge profile that you have a buzz cut. Because they're going to be pissed if they show up without hair.
Nah, dude, I can rock a buzz cut. It might even be like a...
Yeah, okay, but what if a girl's hot as shit? No, for real. What if a girl was really cute in her pictures and then you showed up and then she just had her bangs cut like right here? You'd be like, you should have told me. What if she showed up...
But what if the bang, she like rocks bangs better than the profile pics?
Yeah, like that's a 0.2% chance that that happens.
Well, I'm part of the 0.2% that rocks a buzz cut better than...
If you want to stake your marriage on it, okay.
Marriage.
I'm assuming first date you go on, you're marrying. You're just that type of guy.
Yeah.
Unless
it's all business.
Unless you let me line you up. Mm-hmm. Then I know you're a little more sporadic and crazy.
I mean, I don't know if I have a choice at this point.
Fuck yeah.
We're fucking, locked in.
I sent a video to my landlord, but she already hates us. She just assumes everything that goes wrong in my apartment is like my fault. Like somehow we thumped and thrashed the door into the wall probably. So she's not going to answer my text until tomorrow. So we're fucking stuck here. So maybe I'll give myself a haircut again. And then you get a haircut. We actually just have to wait for TJ to get back. He's going to lose his shit. He's going to break the door down, I feel like, when he comes back in.
And we just never close it ever again.
I guess not. Damn. Zam.
Fucking got it.
I mean...
Nope, not true.
I mean, it's proof right here. You're behind the camera. I'm the one holding
it. I opened it and then got the camera.
You're just such a hardworking guy.
Yes. Dude, imagine if I didn't work for you, you'd be stuck in your apartment for the rest of your life.
I'm like stuck here fucking 24/7 anyways. What do you think we do to make sure it doesn't happen again?
Butter. Jelly. Lube.
We've got lube. I actually don't think we have butter or jelly. It's a sick American household. Someone doesn't have butter or jelly, they have lube.
I would definitely throw lube on the door.
I think she's coming up. You're about to see Nick V. Landlord, version 1. Oh, fuck it, it's TJ, never mind. Dude, our door was stuck. You couldn't open it from the inside for like the last 40 minutes.
What happened?
Should we just try closing it again?
No. If we close it, somebody needs to be on the outside just in case.
That's true.
Do it. What's going to happen?
We weren't here. All right.
So three of us get stuck.
You have to kick the door in to get in here in the first
place. All right, close it.
Watch. See how tight it gets here?
Uh-huh. Open it.
Okay. Maybe it was just like a two-time.
Was it caught? So there's like, look at that right there. Look at that thing at the top. See how the thing is kind of split? The wood's kind of split?
Yeah, I think that's
maybe it was like caught underneath or something?
Dumb, yeah. The first two times when he came, when he needed to kick the door in from the outside to get in, uh-huh. I thought he was holding it when I was trying to open it for him. Uh-huh. And then this last time, he was trying to get out to like get a haircut, couldn't get out, and then...
And you kicked it down?
No, we just ripped it off. Yeah. We couldn't get out from the inside. I sent a video to our landlord.
Oh, yikes.
I was like, before I take the doorknob off, I'm letting you know we can't open it from the inside.
Oh my gosh.
We're going to put some jelly in this motherfucker. All right. This is definitely going to happen to us again when not on camera. We're inside the apartment, but we can't open it from inside. It's like the door is stuck against... the wall, like really tight. No room for error.
Oh
no.
Oh boy.
Yeah. Fan this?
Sure.
Okay.
Oh, let's be your.
Sorry, say that again?
Bro, come on, fan it. Turn it off, dude. Turn it off.
Okay. Yeah, sure. Okay, thank you. I didn't hear a word she just fucking said. I just didn't want her hearing that in the back. Right here. Give me a
dude, honestly, yeah. Just turn it off. I don't know how to.
No, dude, they don't open. Neither of them open.
You gotta take the tin foil off.
No, they don't open. They don't open, TJ. Dude, they don't open, bro.
Okay, well, if they do...
They just slam right down shut, I'm telling you. Yo, how the fuck do we turn...
You just turn it off.
How, though?
Just stand on a chair.
Do we have a chair?
We can't get a chair. We can't...
Hey, let's fucking go.
This chair right here. Adventures with our landlord.
Fucking worth it.
Look at this fucking video.
Fix it, same old, hit us with the 15 seconds and skip a bit. It's fucking YouTube farce behavior 101. Never put unskippable ads in your videos.
Using plastic bottle and a soda can. The press of it, okay. Time to...
Bro.
Okay. But you see that one here.
We're just gonna have to live with a door that doesn't open all the time.
No, dude, we gotta get it fixed. She has a maintenance guy, and I'm actually kind of frustrated we don't have his number. That's like very, just like very 101 apartment shit.
Yeah.
Woo! Whatever 101.
This asparagus is phenomenal. This is the best I've ever cooked it. Here's what you do. Put a pot on the stove, really fucking high. Nothing on it, no oil, no spray, nothing like that. Put it like borderline as high as your stove goes. Let it get piping hot, steaming fucking hot. David Montgomery, week 13 through 17, hot. Then you hit it with the asparagus. You don't put any oil on the asparagus yet either. You can put some seasoning, pepper, salt, whatever. Put it straight on so it's dried up to this point. You're roasting the outside of it by doing that. And then after maybe like a minute and a half, then you throw some oil on it. You can either do spray or you can do olive oil so that when it hits the fucking pan, it starts to blister the outside of the asparagus. So keep it on one side for maybe like a minute and a half, kind of roll it up and flip it around a little bit for another minute, minute and a half. I put too much salt and pepper on this. Don't overdose on seasoning. After that, that'll have crisped the outsides. Put it down a little bit to like low heat. And then I had a lemon and I just squeezed the lemon. TJ, use your lemon, by the way. I owe you one. Don't use your roommate's lemon, buy your own lemon. And I let it sit in the low heat in the lemon for probably like 30 seconds. or until the fire alarm goes off, and then you take it off the stove. And voila, you have beautifully cooked asparagus. Chewy, delicious, nutritious. And it'll make your pee smell fucking awful. That's the most important part.